Good morning and good evening based on the geography in which you are located in. And welcome to Rudra IT Solutions. We have been in this training space for quite a long time, and we actually look at some of the niche skill set like Oracle Advanced Supply Chain Planning, Oracle Demantra, Oracle WMS. So worldwide, if you look at it, you will really get only a handful of consultants who actually know and appreciate this topic. So we have been doing this for quite a long and so we have our own people who can actually take you to the next level. So my name is Sandeep Chatterjee, and I've been working on Oracle Demantra for the last 10 years before it was acquired by Oracle. So I've seen this product before it was acquired, and going forward how it was integrated with Oracle eBiz. So coming to what Oracle Demantra is, we will just go through what we are planning to cover. So if you look at it, we talk about Demantra, you will hear about so many people talk about Demantra. Demantra is nothing but demand planning. So if you look at it, when you are doing your business, you get a sales order. So sales order is nothing but your source of demand. So you get a sales order, you build it, and you ship it to your customer. Or you have an option of buying it from your supplier and giving it to the your customer. Now the point is, do you want to do like this? Do you want to really, it's all about living by the hour, or you want to plan for the future? Now why future planning is important? For example, you now the customer has too many choices. So if you try to buy a book and if it is not available with Amazon, they will go to Flipkart. So similarly, if you don't really plan your supply chain really well, you will not be able to meet your customer demand. The thing is, if you don't do it, somebody else will. It's just not about the price alone. It's also about if you can fulfill a customer's order in 10 days, but if somebody can do it in 2 days, so unless there is a huge variation in price, you lose your customer. So that's why it's very important for you to actually look at on a 2 year or a 3 year horizon, like where you actually forecast, because you need to build inventories as well so that you don't run out of stocks, you don't have a lost customer. So net Demantra is a tool actually which will actually do your forecasting. It's just not forecasting based on past sales history. If you have a new product, how do you arrive at a number that whether how much are you going to sell for the next 1 year? Thing is, Demantra has advanced features like chaining, where it looks at a similar product and it says, okay, this is what it should be. You should be selling this much, this much. And of course, when you run your Demantra engine, it does an actuals versus forecast. And if you look at what is the forecast accuracy. So if your forecast accuracy is heavier, the algorithm will actually tune it so that you get a better forecast. It's like it adjusts the algorithm every time to come at it. So if I net if I look at it, it's a forecasting tool. You can say that what's the big deal? The big deal is it's all about the forecast accuracy. You cannot have 100% accuracy, but if you're close to 95, I think you are doing well. But if you are 50%, I think you are really, it's better, I think you should shut down your business. So it's very important that you get your forecasting thing right, and Oracle Demantra is the right tool to handle that. It's the best in the market. I can vouch for it. The history of Demantra is was a different product altogether, and Oracle had its own Oracle demand planning software, and once it acquired Demantra, it gave all the integrations, and they are no more selling Oracle demand planning. They are actually selling Demantra. So it's the best product in the market. They call it as a PhD in a box. Like, it has some 26 algorithms which run when you run your engine. So if I look at overview, we will just talk about what is Demantra, why customers deploy it, what are the business needs, what are the competitors of Demantra, what are the various releases, because it's software is very important that what release of, because again it's a planning software and you have to understand whether it is compatible with your transaction system. So all this becomes very, very important, and we'll talk about what are the Demantra differentiators, we'll talk about Demantra features and glossary, we'll talk about what is the architecture, Of course, Demantra have actually 5 modules. So we, if you look at it, here we call about Demantra DM, which is the demand management. And we also have an advanced forecasting and demand management. We call it as an AFDM, which has some additional statistical capabilities. So this covers 2 modules. And then on day 2, we actually look at what is the level, what is the series. Level is at what level of Demantra are you forecasting? Is it at an SKU level, or is it a product family level, or is it as a number of warehouses, or at a warehouse level, or you want to have more granularity? Series is something, what kind of Demantra series which you want to run, whether it's a 10-month moving average or a 9-month moving average. So there are some 26 algorithms which take into that. Worksheet is what a planner works with. Worksheet actually will give you what is your history, what is the forecast. You can override your forecast because it goes through multiple approvals, because as a sales manager you can have your forecast, but it has to be approved by your regional manager and finally by your sales head. So it has a hierarchy of structure where you actually get a history, Demantra will give a forecast, you override the forecast, and it so on and so forth. Next is something called a collaborator workbench, which is very, very critical, because when you something have called a sales meet, where everybody has to key in the numbers. So you can have something like a collaborator where everybody logs in and everybody can see everybody what everybody is doing. It also has a small chat window where you can actually freeze your numbers. This becomes very helpful for the sales function. Then you have your workflows, which actually it's similar to an Oracle workflow, where actually if there is any event, you can get an alert. Then there are some what are the security, who will access to what data, and of course you have a admin tool, because when you build the models, and very limited people should have access to that one. Then we talk in detail about what is the collaborator workbench, then we talk about worksheets, we talk about Demantra levels, hierarchies, dimensions, we talk about security and user management, we talk about database objects and new product. Of course, we're talking about new product introduction, how will you forecast, so there is something called chaining. And then we talk about the engine, because you need to, engine parameters actually become very, very critical. Unless you are an expert in that, you really cannot tune an engine. And then also we talk about some of the causal factors. Thing is, if it's a Diwali sale, you know that. So you put a causal factor there. So Demantra will actually take care of all these causal factors. And then we, and to be very honest, it's also a very, very technical product, because if you are thinking that you can only work with the front end, it doesn't work, because a lot of, there are only 7 tables in Demantra, but if you look at it, you also need to have run some queries, because it's all about data. So you also need to have a fair bit of understanding on the back end as well. And then we also talk about Demantra predictive treatment, which is another module of Demantra, and there are some integrations built with EBIS. We will talk in detail about that. So I will just now, I will give a snapshot of what we are going to cover. This is actually a Oracle standard slide where it talks about where Demantra lies. It's for demand sensing and demand shaping. And then if you look at it, these are the some of the modules which we're talking about Demantra. You have demand management, which comes in 2 flavors. One's the CTO and the spare parts forecasting. Then you have something called advanced forecasting and demand modeling, which is AFDM we talked about. Then there is something called RTSNOP, which is your actually sales and operations planning. Then you also have something called predictive trade planning, and you also have deduction settlement management. So net-net, there are actually about 5 modules in Demantra, and this is how the integration looks like. So it's integrated with your ASCP, your SNO, your global order promising, and also with EBIS, and also we have integrations with Siebel CRM and JD Edwards as well. So then we talked briefly about what is demand management, why it is crucial, then what are the key features of Demantra, and then this is how a collaborative workbench looks like, where you actually can collaborate across your functions. Then this is what a worksheet is, where you can see all your figures in the name of workbench, and you know, what are the graphs. So it's all about data. Then this is how your work, C12.2 has some enhanced features in Demantra, where you actually look at graphical views as well. Of course, there's a color coding where you get an alert that if it is more than 66%, it has a different green, and if it's 0%, it has a red. So it also has a very, very good expressive where you can actually color code, and it's a visual, because we all know that visual gives a more appeal to the brain rather than text. Of course, we have workflow-enabled collaboration, and we also talk about how it actually workflow runs for data exchange between stakeholders. We also talk about workflow manager, which becomes very critical, because if your workflow is not running, I think you will not get your alerts. Then we also talk about some of the statistical forecasting capabilities. What are the, there's a Bayesian Markov algorithm, which is actually Oracle's proprietary algorithm. And there we talk about causal factors, like there are holidays, there's Thanksgiving, there's Christmas, there's Diwali, there is Durga Puja. So all these factors can be actually built in Demantra. And of course, we talk about what is the data model. You will actually have, because Demantra, I said that it has too much of a technicality, so you really need to understand what is a hierarchy, what is a level, what is a series. So we will go through each of these definitions in detail, because unless you have a very good understanding of this, you really cannot do it. So if you really have any further questions on that, you can always go to www.rudraitsolutions.com, and we will be more than happy to assist you.